the best and the most beautiful things in the world cannot be seen, nor even touched, but just felt in the heart. Nothing can illustrate this passage more accurately than a game of blindfold. A game where you are plunged into a world of darkness and a challenge is set before you to accomplish. The game of blindfold takes one to a world beyond vision that transcends the physical. It provides a glimpse to the world characterized by the enhanced senses of touch, smell, and hearing. For some, this game gets over during their playtime hours, but there exist a few others who get ensnared in this game for a lifetime. The game then becomes their real life, and every task set before them becomes a challenge to conquer.
The story of development, people aspirations, they would personally like to do, would to do certain things and achieve certain goals. They all have ideas about what their country should like.
One such personality stands as a living example for many. She comes as a ray of hope to the unfortunate few who are left baffled and traumatized when confronted with the adverse situations meted out by life.
Has got a lot of potential in her. She's very intelligent and she was going through in the college despite the problems that she had. She was managing with excellent marks.
She was my teacher and she is still my teacher.
And I really admire her for what she is.
I'm a teacher, okay? A teacher and a special educator. Okay. I would like to be remembered like that. I did my schooling, I did my college, my master's as any other students because I still had my eyesight then. And I had dreams to become a psychiatric social worker. That was one dream. But then because of the failing eyesight, all my dreams fell apart and the other dreams also, you know, as any other young lady would have for a life. It wasn't such a good time then because then I knew that I was losing something that was very important to me and I would have to adjust to a newer life. I tried to look into avenues that would give me that, you know, that peace of mind, that a contentment or a sense of being someone, because when I lost my eyesight, I think I lost my identity also. It was hard, it was discouraging, it was sad, it was an angry time, but then there's that good part in me, or there's what I discovered later, the spiritual influence that I got, and when I experience, you know, the joy, the salvation of believing in a savior, then my life changed.
She firmly believes in the saying, "We are all faced with a series of great opportunities, brilliantly disguised as an impossible situations." And along similar line, she asserts that no opportunity that comes one's way should be left unexplored, but grabbed and utilized to reach one's goal in life.
We are what we are because of the opportunities that have been made available for us. What we are to do in life is to make the most, to do justice to the opportunity that we get and give the best that we have, whether we are disabled or not disabled.
Her calling for giving purpose to and molding the lives of several is fulfilled through her attachment to the Jyoti Sroat School. Established in the year 1993, the Jyoti Sroat School, which was initially started for the blind, had a student strength of only 4. But with the course of time, it has now become inclusive with increased student strength of 170 students ranging from preparatory classes to the 10th standard.
I joined the school as a teacher. In fact, it was quite blurred to me also what would be my role. But then over the years, with the training that I got in braille skills and mobility skills, when I learned to adjust with the visual impairment that had befallen me, then I understood that my role in the school was a teacher and also a person to represent other children with visual impairment. When the school came up, then the education department also realized that there is a need for educating children with visual impairment. They would have liked to start a school of their own. But then our request was that even if they supported our school or they started their own school, that they would accept the code, the Khasi code, because by then for 2 or 3 years the children had been using that. My association with the school has become so close now that I feel that it is a part of me.
When I came here and I joined the school, I really found myself growing in so many ways. And then it has also taught me a lot of things, being with the children. And in fact, I'm very lucky to be teaching in this school.
The school is quite good. It's better than the other schools I have experienced in my life.
Jisem dong ate ka bhai ka bit ka school nian marong long ngi pat ya la di ba ngi di ba duk ma te long ka bit hi.
In a midst of her various accomplishments, the one endeavor undertaken by her which stands out is her incorporating of the braille code in the Khasi language, which follows a Roman script in its written form.
The need was there because the children need to read and write in their mother tongue. And then later also, the board prescribes that now the first language is the mother tongue. So the need had been there. And since I was the Khasi teacher around, I would be in a better position to develop the Khasi Braille code. Compiling the code wasn't so difficult because I was given a good grounding in English Braille. I was taught the rules, taught the nitty-gritties of Braille. So it helped me into compiling the Braille code. And that was further facilitated because our Khasi language script is still the Roman script. It was just accepting the ones that are similar and rejecting others or adding others regarding the letters and the vowels and consonants.
A number of awards and recognitions were conferred on Ms. Bertha for her extensive contribution and services towards the visually impaired. Ms. Bertha has also been awarded the Child Welfare National Award and several Teachers Awards in 2008 and 9 successively. In the same vein, students of her school are also following her footsteps and winning accolades from all quarters. With a new hope of tomorrow instilled in them, they are marching forward in the mainstream of India like any other, oblivious of their handicap.
My name is Dylan Fokmoblai and I've joined this school since 2001. And I find the school very interesting and very benefit for me, and the teachers also very, what to say, they love, they like me very much, and me also, I love them very much.
They are different individually, and they also come from very individualized backgrounds. More than the physical disability that comes with the child, we see more of the emotional instability in them. Out of 10 children that come, maybe there may be just one or two who are emotionally stable. Others, because of a bad background or because of abuse or because of neglect or because of poverty, then they become very depressed children, kind of hopeless. So what we want to deal first with is the emotional aspect. We want to make them feel that they are accepted for what they are.
Besides teaching regular subjects like science, English, mathematics, Khasi, etc., the school provides the students the opportunity to cultivate a taste and instruction in the soul-soothing art of music. In fact, Jyoti Shod boasts of its own musical band formed with the students who, though visually impaired, are well versed in playing different musical instruments.
Seeing them, it's a bit hard for me, you know. And I thought to myself, how will I teach them? But first of all, you really need patience, you know. Yeah. And especially the drums, the keyboards, and since they don't have eyes, you know, like they use their ears, so it's a little bit hard for me to teach them before. As I go on practicing, you know, blindfold myself and then play the drums and feels their, how they feel. It was a good experience for me also.
In addition to this, the school also imparts instruction in computers specifically devised for the blind, which helps them to become aware of the wonders of technology and the internet. Jyoti Shod also provides facilities of both boys and girls hostel with a boarding strength of 50 students in each. Every morning, the hostel buzzes with the numerous activities undertaken by the boarders, like washing, making beds, watering the plants, cleaning, etc. A glimpse of the activities in the hostel shows these differently able students at their element, doing all the chores of regular boarders with the dexterity and skill of any other person. The parents of the children studying at the school are full of praise for Miss Bertha for her work towards helping their wards. To them, she is the pathfinder who guides the bewildered and gives them a definite direction to their life.
Long miss iba sutanat ba bat iba kloy ban nyerap ya kinu kinu kena kan ya ba juan pan jengerap nei nam ta ka school wat aduk dakimla ban siu ka bai school ikloy ban padiang.
Now I hear people saying directly to me, you know, the appreciation. And now they understand. And then people tell others, oh, now we understand what the school is for, that these children are capable of so many things.
Lumlang and Sunya went to the terrace through the stairs to take the flower pots.
About it, I would love to start writing some books or some articles. I would love to do many things, but I would like to be more of a person whom people can come to.
Even though we are having problems with eyes or hearing or anything, but still we don't give up. We have the courage to face the world, and to face the world is we should try hard. We should never give up, and God always looks from the heaven and He never forgets our prayers.
In the course of few days spent in documenting, Ms. Bertha and the Jyoti Shod School we came in touch with a world full of laughter and brightness. We caught a glimpse of a world which, though far from utopian, can almost be called ideal, continuously ringing with joyous laughter, even in the shadow of veiled tears. A world felt by touch, by the cacophony of sounds, and the aroma inhaled with each blessed breath. A world that taught us all about humility, pain, adversity, challenges, intertwined with the tales of laughter, hope, success, marching forward with confidence and determination.
Have you seen the sunset fade beneath the rain cloud? Have you ever chased your dreams away? Did you ever think that life was just a highway? Never-ending road of lonely days. There are times we cry and reach out to the sky for the strength we need to hold our head up high. Oh, all we have to do now is love one another, sisters and brothers. We all need